Hi everyone, Lisa Haven here. Well, Pope Francis is on a rampage to not only begin the One World Order, but also ignite his One World Religion. I'm talking about him building a facility in UAE where he brings together a synagogue, a mosque, and a church. Basically, the throne or house of the false prophet. Take a look at this article on skywatch.tv, the final pope's One World Abrahamic family house to combine a church, a mosque, and a synagogue, preparation for the horror of Babylon. ChristianPost.com, Abrahamic family house, church, mosque, and synagogue to share new complex in United Arab Emirates. The article goes on, plans were revealed for the construction of an interfaith complex that will house a church, a synagogue, and a mosque in the UAE as part of an effort to promote religious harmony and bridge adherence of the three Abrahamic religions. The complex, known as the Abrahamic Family House, will be located in Sadat Island near Abu Dhabi. The project is a result of Roman Catholic Pope Francis's papal visit to Abu Dhabi in February, when the pontiff and the Grand Imam Al-Zahr in Egypt signed a declaration establishing the Interfaith Higher Committee of Human Fraternity. On the screen right now, you can see the proposed facility, and it literally has three separate buildings. Each of those buildings will house one of the three religions. One would be the Jews, one would be the Christians, one would be the Muslims. And then in the middle there, you actually see a courtyard gathering place. Let's just call this facility what it is. The One World Religion with the Pope as the dictator. This is basically the formation of a new religion under one head, the papacy head, a false prophet head, which is spoken of in the book of Revelation. We are literally seeing this come to pass before our eyes. But the good news is there are people starting to stand against the Pope's reign and dictates and rules and regulations, you see, because Pope Francis has made it clear that he is a socialist. He is a communist socialist. Not only that, but he made it very clear that he supports climate change and the hoax of climate change. Basically, he believes in Agenda 2030 and supports Agenda 21. He believes in mass migration and open borders. These are all progressive socialist communist mentalities that he is pushing. Well, not everyone in the papacy agrees with him. In fact, according to some, there are coups being ignited against him. Take a look at this article on express.co.uk published October 10th of this year. Pope Francis' threat of a religious coup from traditionalists in Catholic Church. It goes on, Pope Francis is under a threat in the Vatican as his predecessor, Pope Benedict, along with other traditionalist wing of Catholic Church, backed by former Donald Trump strategist Steve Bannon, thank you, look to undermine his papacy, according to journalist Wayne Madsen. Here's another on express.co.uk, Pope Francis on the brink, threat from Salvini against Vatican leader exposed. It goes on, Pope Francis is facing a potential religious coup from within the Catholic Church. But there is also an emerging threat from outside the Vatican as Italian populist Matteo Salvini sets his sight on the progressive Pope. Now, I can't say for certain if there is or isn't a coup, but what I can say is that we have people who are politically standing against the Pope and recognize that some of the things that he's doing are 100% outside of, well, what they normally do. You see, the problem with the Pope right now is many people are upset because I believe he's appointed around 128 cardinals, which is unheard of, and all of them have his same socialist Jesuit kind of beliefs, either one or the other in some way, shape, or form, which means a lot of the cardinals, this Council of Cardinals, has turned into a majority of progressive and socialist communist. So some of the traditionalist Catholics in the cardinalship are not happy about that because he's literally making it a one-sided politics and people aren't happy. And the other part of this is Pope Francis is now basically standing against those who oppose him by basically saying those who oppose the Pope kind of oppose God. Take a look at this article here on cruxnow.com. Cardinal Sarah says to oppose the Pope is to be outside of the church. So in other words, what they're trying to say is all those traditional Catholics, traditional cardinals who oppose him are outside of the church. which means they don't have a voice. They shouldn't be able to speak. They're not right under what God is saying. You see how they twist it? So now, because if you stand on a political, if you're more conservative, suddenly you're being hindered and pushed away. If you're one of those cardinals that have more conservative views, or bishops, or anyone within the Catholic Church. And they're really dictating it not only to them, but to the entire body, if you will. Oppose the Pope. You're outside the dictates of God. Give me a break. We all know the real agenda here. You see, you even denied Pope Francis, Jesus Christ. Check out this article. This is on ChristianPost.com. Pope Francis, atheist friend, claims pontiff told him Jesus incarnate was not at all God. Now the Pope denies it. He says that, of course. But the atheist has no benefit to get on public air and start saying that, other than if the Pope actually said it. But nonetheless, the Pope has already done many things that attack Christianity specifically. Anyhow, I'd love to get your thoughts, comments, and concerns on that. What do you think? And please don't forget to check out my partner at NobleGoldInvestments.com. If you've not converted your 401k into something back by precious metals, gold and silver, these kind of things, please do so now. As you know, the economy is unstable. There's only so much time, and you want to protect your retirement. So you can do that by calling Noble Gold Investments and let them know you heard it on Lisa Haven. Anyhow, thanks again for tuning in. I'm Lisa Haven, signing out.